Welcome back to The Exchange. Bank of America's latest COVID housing impact survey shows that that so-called urban exodus of people moving from cities to suburbs may be something of an urban legend. I don't believe it. For more, I'm joined by John Lavallo. He's the home builders analyst at Bank of America Securities. John, I mean, where we are, it's been blowing up with demand. But I take your point. Look, our Robert Frank has a story today about new leases in Manhattan having their strongest November in 12 years. So tell us what you think is going on here.
Yeah. Hey, Kelly, thank you for having me. So it's interesting. We ran a survey for about 6 months. First 3 months of the survey, there was very little differential between urban dwellers and suburban dwellers in terms of their responses. Most really didn't cite a desire to move because of COVID. It was around 18%. More recently, that's changed pretty dramatically, where suburban dwellers moved up to about 34% saying COVID had an impact, while the urban counterparts only had about 20%, so very little move. So the entire move up has been from suburban folks. What I think is happening, you know, frankly, the largest or most overwhelming response was people looking for a slower pace of living. Now, you would think that that might correspond more to city dwellers moving out, but it was really more on the suburban side. So I think that, you know, look, there's a lot of great things about living in the city. As a vaccine starts coming into, you know, more into a reality here, I think you could see even less folks wanting to move out of the city.
Yeah, so Roberts, when he spoke with brokers, they also said there's a couple of factors here in terms of all of a sudden this surge in leasing demand in Manhattan. They said millennials living with their parents, quote, can't take it anymore, want to move back to the city. And suburbanites who couldn't resist selling, I mean, this is such a seller's market right now. If you're selling, maybe you go into the city and you're renting for a little while. So let's boil this down to what it means for investors. You know, how does it affect the home builders trade, which has been a huge performer, but one of the more controversial ones right now as to how much, you know, I would say how much legs it has, so to speak.
Yeah, no, I think that's exactly right. I mean, the fundamentals are still incredibly strong for the home building industry. We have certain concerns about the stocks themselves, given the fact that home price appreciation is moving up pretty markedly. Interest rates could continue to creep up here from here. And frankly, the stocks have had tremendous run, and the comps are going to be very challenging. The way we think you have to play the home builders at this point is you need to be focused on builders that can go into an existing market and compete with the existing stock of homes that are in that market. And existing home supply is very low. It's about 2.5 months across the country. So you need a builder like D.R. Horton, which is our top pick, that actually can compete on a price from a price standpoint and an availability standpoint with the existing stock in each market. And I think that that's where the most need-based buyers are. So if things get, affordability starts running off a little bit, I think that, you know, the need-based is important.
So if D.R. Horton is maybe best positioned to take advantage of these trends playing out, who does that make you think twice about? I mean, is there anybody you have a sell rating on here?
So Toll Brothers is our sell rating in the group right now. Very well-run company, very well-positioned company. However, we think that the luxury buyer is a little bit less, or a little bit more discretionary, I should say. So if things get tough from an affordability standpoint, that buyer may say, hey, you know what, maybe we'll delay for a little while. Whereas someone who maybe just got married or just had children and need more space, I think that that buyer will buy less home, but they'll probably continue to buy a home.
All right. And there's Toll down about 4% over the past week. John, thanks for joining us today and appreciate your thoughts, especially as out of consensus as they are right now.